Most people in life are looking for how do I make a life worth living and a retirement worth having. When I begin my audio cast or my video cast with this phrase and mantra, I'm really saying this is my intellectual property. Please don't take it, don't steal it, don't ruin it, and don't fucking put your fucking fingers in my pants so you can feel it out. I've had people steal my thumb drives, absolutely. Law enforcement stole 24 thumb drives of mine. They stole federally protected records of mine, from my birth certificates to my driving certificates to everything I needed for my life. So if you expect me to love law enforcement, that's not going to happen in this lifetime. If you expect me to love siblings, that's not going to happen in this lifetime. They all stood against a person that I loved very much in a court of law. So why would I ever consider their lies and their betrayal something important to me at all? Now when I talk about this, let's talk about you, little person on campus. There's plenty of you that have been watching my video channel and actually playing up to me, trying to play with me with what you say to me. But let's be clear, how old are you? Motherfucker, how old are you? Have you ever read the U.S. Constitution? If you haven't, then maybe you're not really an American citizen. If you've not read our amendments to that Constitution, then maybe you're not ready for your life. If you have not read anything on medical law, HIPAA law, privacy law, technology law, telecommunications law, then maybe you're just not ready for your adult life. You see, we all have responsibilities in life, but those responsibilities in life begin and end with our individual life. At the time in which we have a betrothal, at the time in which we get married, we then become somewhat liable, legally so and lethally so, to our spouse. But if our spouse is a moron, if our spouse is a shithead, if our spouse destroys family reunions and family events, then openly maybe they're the wrong spouse for your life. Because most likely you're going to be tainted. You're going to become tainted, you're going to become bitter, you're going to become hateful, you're going to become a Twitter, and I don't mean by the Twitter account, I mean somebody who just wants to spout off every 2 seconds, that you never actually learned how to listen. You see, to listen is to listen clearly to someone's perspective, someone's situation, someone's ideology, and go, huh, I could see how you think that way, but here's what I know about the law. Here's what I know about truth. You see, the truth is still the truth. And what is true is often truth, and what is truth is often not true to some people. But that doesn't mean it's untrue. You see, the truth is that American citizens live within the lines of the law. And the lines of the law protect the individual and every fucking record that they personally, individually have. It is not a group that owns a person's individual life. That is a foolishness, that is a lie you make to yourself, and openly we're going to teach you that every single minute of your life. Because what I've seen on campus is boys taking away the rights of young girls. A young girl wants to help someone, a young girl wants to protect someone, a young girl wants to buy something, a young girl wants to say something, and some boy she barely knows is trying to tell her, no, you can't do that. I'm sorry, who are you to tell her that? She can do and say and be anything she wants to become. And the same is the same for a man in the world. That men have very different relationships with each other is absolute truth. But here's what we know about men who have never achieved enough in their life. Men who have never really agreed enough to strategic or profitable partnerships to make a real life is that they are constantly looking and raging and hungry for power in their life. But oftentimes they don't take the power in their life. They actually step outside of their own life bounds and move into somebody else's boundaries, somebody else's life, and really monkey around. They do it for the fun of it. They do it for the thrill of it. They do it to see if they'll ever get caught by law enforcement. But the stupidity of it is that they just monkey their whole life because they become enslaved to that other life. And my guess is that person doesn't know you at all, doesn't like you at all, doesn't want you in their life at all because of how stupid you look to them. So let's be real. If you're monkeying someone else's life, whether you believe in God or not, the karma is going to catch you. Your lies are going to catch up with you because laws are laws. And federal law protects the individual's rights to every single person part of their life. Their heart, their mind, their soul, and particularly their body. You may not commandeer someone's body to do with it what you like. That is a lie you've told yourself underneath the religious right. You do not have rights to someone's paperwork. Their paperwork is what protects their life. Their paperwork is what protects their bodies. Their paperwork is what protects their medical privacies. Their paperwork is what protects their legalities in where they live and how they stay and what they do all day long. Their paperwork protects their employment or their business. It doesn't belong to you. At the same time, under the Fourth Amendment, The third thing that's protected, our possessions, that we have the right to be safe in our personhood, our paperwork, and our property, is clearly written there in the U.S. Constitution or the amendments of it. So give me a fucking break. I do not belong to you. I'm not your plaything. I'm not your plaything. I'm going to sit on a fucking public sidewalk and make my recording, and you're not going to say one fucking thing to me, motherfucker, because you are not me. I am not you, and you will not tell me what I can do in this world. Or I will come into your fucking house and tell you what to do with your spouse, and tell you what to do with your children, and tell you what to do in your job, and you won't like it one fucking bit because you didn't employ me to do that. You didn't assign me to do that. You didn't ask my advice to do that. So if I make this thing really passionate and powerful, I'm telling you, stay the fuck out of people's rights. This is America. It's not a fucking third world country, and you fucked your life playing in my life.